Okay, everybody, today we're going to do something a little bit interesting. This is a two-team game that I've got going on. And what I thought I would try to teach you guys today is how to figure out which team somebody's on and then make something happen. So this game is a Capture the Cabbage game. I think I've introduced this to you before. If you're new, then you've never seen it. But in a past tutorial, I've talked about this a couple of times. So what happens is when I capture the cabbage, I pick it up, then immediately we get a guy and he's got a pickaxe and he's going to get me. But that only happens for team number one. For team number two, which has to go back the other way, over that way, there'll be a different guy that shows up over here and tries to get him. The weird thing is this guy shouldn't have a pickaxe and he should be able to move. There's a weird bug, but I'll show you how to fix that as well. If this ever happens to you, you get a guard spawner that shows up with a pickaxe, but he's supposed to have something else. It's so strange. Anyhow, okay, let's get into how to make this. Okay, so here we are inside of UEFN. I'm in the middle of what is the arena of this game. And in the middle is my cabbage. And this is a capture item spawner. So you can see if you look in your devices and put in capture, there's a capture area and a capture item spawner. So these two go hand in hand. It's a capture a thing game. I'm using cabbage in this instance. But you need a capture area and a capture item spawner. We don't care. Well, we care a little bit about the capture area, actually. So we will talk about that. So the capture spawner has a cabbage in it. And what we want to do is we want to subscribe to the on item picked up and on item captured as well. So we want to catch that as well. But we want to find out when somebody picks it up. And then these two guards are on different teams. So this is team, this is team one's guard. And this guy over here is team two's guard because team two starts on the left, team one starts on the right. So when you have to go back and take your cabbage back, this team one guard will try to stop the player from doing that, and this team two guard will stop the other player from doing that. So let's head up to team one's spot, and we'll see that we've got our capture area here. This is where the cabbage has to be brought back to. Now, the idea is that when you bring back the item, the guard that's guarding the cabbage disappears. So we're gonna grab that as well. But we gotta first make them show up. So to do that, we need to go into our game management device. And mine lives inside of this creative devices here, Super Game Manager. We open up the code for this and take a look at how to do this. Now, if you don't know how to get to this part, I do have more simple tutorials on how to get to this part in a different tutorial, but I'd just be recovering it anyways. So let's not do that. Let's talk about what goes on here. So when we want to listen to particular devices, we have to make them editable. So all of my my cabbage spawner, my team one capture area, my team two capture area, team one guard spawner, team two guard spawner are all editables. And so if we take a look over in the details panel, we can see that we've got all of these items set up, except for the capture areas. I guess I could do that now. Team one capture area and team two capture. You don't actually need to use these. Interestingly, you can just use the spawning, the item capture item spawner device to capture the capture, to subscribe to the capture event. So, and that's fine. So on begin starts with, we want the cabbage spawner, in this case, the capture item spawner, on item picked up and on item captured event. The on item captured event means that they brought it back to the capture area. So it will know it because it gets the object back for the other team to go get. And you have to do that three times in this game. So we do on cabbage pickup and on cabbage captured. So here in on cabbage captured, it doesn't matter the despawn. So for every guard spawner, they have a spawn and a despawn function you can call on them to make something happen. We're going to use that. Despawn can fail. Like if the guard isn't even there, then it can just fail straight out. So we can call despawn on both of them when the cabbage is captured from either side. It doesn't matter. If we want to do even more, then we'll make this more detailed, but for now this is good enough. So here comes the meat of the whole thing. On cabbage picked up, It passes in both of these captured and picked up passes in the agent, so we can get the character. And then we save the team collections from the play space object in a variable, or actually it's a constant, named team collection. And then agent's team is the team. So team collection get team, we will call on the agent. And that will get us which team they're on. Okay. And then, so we do an if for that though, because this is an optional. This could fail. So we wrap it in an if then statement. So then if this succeeds, then we go to the teams array. We make a teams array object and we put the teams into there. And what this is going to do is it's going to make an array of the teams. Now arrays start with 0, 1, 2 in verse. So we want to know if you're on team index 1, then we're going to get 0. Team index 2 is going to be the first, or the number 1, the index 1. So 0 is the first, which is the team index that we set for the player. Let's take a look at that. So if we go over to my player 1 spawner, we can see that the player team is set to a team index of 1, and the other one is set to 2. So that way, inside of our code, we'll know that they're in the array of teams in the 0 spot, 1, or the 1 spot, which is team index 2. And we'll check that out. So you're sort of hard coding in a way how this gets done. But we'll tell the team 2 guard spawner to spawn for team 1, which is in the 0 slot of the array. And if they're in the second slot, which is the first, the one index of the array, because it starts at 0, then we do the team one guard spawner to spawn their guard so they can get the cabbage back. and that's it. That's how you figure out which team somebody is on, and then respond to that accordingly by doing a thing in your game. So it's easier than I thought it would be. It took me a little while to figure out, so I thought I would share with you guys. Some people are going to be looking for it like I was looking for it. So here it is. Hopefully that's kind of interesting. And one more thing. We'll also go and fix the guard. Now, sometimes UEFN will oddly, it seems to happen when you kind of close things up or you do something. I'm not really sure why it happens, but if your guard stops, see, he should have a gun and he should have some bullets with him. But he should be able to move around, but he can't. So when this happens, what I usually do is I just grab another guard spawner. So guard spawner right here. And I bring him in and flip him around because he's supposed to be facing it. So I just essentially duplicate it, but by not duplicating. So we don't duplicate it. We make a new one, but we're duplicating this. And I know that he has a couple of things in his inventory. One is an assault rifle level 5. I'll just go find that. This one. And I gave him a bunch of bullets too. So we'll go find the ammo, which is a medium ammo. Medium, and I set that to 100. And then we want to set the index, the team index for this guy. So the team index is going to be 2. Because he's on the player 2 side. So just like this guy. We look here, it says 2. And then what we can do, and I also set up his health and shield to be 200, or his shield to be 100. Max health, 200. Starting shield, 100. Max shield, 100. Oh, and also set it up so you can see really far. So 200 range, I think. The patrol distance I set to 200. So he can go really, he can follow you all the way back to your, you can only see 40 though. So visibility set to 40. And I think that's everything. Oh, and I also set it to high for accuracy. So I guess I've covered a little bit of how to set up a guard to do a certain thing. So we'll take this guy and delete. Oh, yeah. And I also need the spawning radius to be smaller because it's way too big. And then we'll move him back. Hit W. Move him back over to here. And now this should make the guard work properly again. So actually, maybe we'll test that really quick just to show you guys. So we'll save. We'll build our verse code. I don't think I changed anything. And save one more time. No, nothing to save. Good. Push changes and wait. Okay, after a little while of waiting, we finally have this game going. I got to admit, this is the hardest part of working with UEFN is to wait to see your changes update across the server. But that's just a complaint. The other thing I actually did off camera was change the guard spawning amount and on a timer. So I took off the timer and set the default amount to 1 so that there is only one guard that comes out. And he doesn't come out automatically. So on a timer, they'll come out automatically. So cabbage. Get the cabbage. Oh my god. So here's a common problem. Let's end the game. When you end up trying to fix these bugs that they put in, you end up tending to forget to do certain things. So inside of our device that controls our game, the guard no longer works. So as you can see, I've already done this with a new guard spawner. I didn't rename my next guard spawner, so it's just guard spawner. And so we're going to use that one. And that will link up, because remember, it's an editable item. So that will link up the guard to our code now. And so now we can actually play. So let's save that. Push our changes, wait 20 minutes, and we'll be able to play it again and test. Try not to make mistakes with your game development. It will cost you in time with this platform. Okay, we're back with another test round. Let's grab this fast car this time, because we put all kinds of things in this game. Although it doesn't go very fast on gravel. Or get through the gate. That's better. Okay, let's go get the cabbage one more time. Okay, we got our guard. He's got his gun. He hasn't seen me yet. Let's shoot him in the butt. There we go. Okay, so you see now that he works. So we fixed that problem. We've got him to do some things. So there we go. Let's make him dance. And then run. Anyhow, that's that. Hopefully this has been a little bit interesting. He's still shooting me. I know what's up here, so let's get up here. Grab this. Anybody still here watching this? Nah. Poke your head up. Oh. Oh, I missed. Oh no. And that's that. It looks like I forgot to not have his item drop. So we want to put that in as well. Oh, if only they would fix all the bugs. All right, that's it for this one. I'll see you guys in the next one.